Today, the Iraq inquiry will be hearing from the Right Honourable Tony Blair, Prime Minister from 1997 until June 2007.
At Nuremberg in 1945, it was ruled that deliberately falsifying news to arouse those passions which lead to atrocities is a war crime.
We've been told that in number 10, the Prime Minister and Alistair Campbell expressed approval of the Sun's coverage.
Stop squirming!
Now the Sun accused the French president of being
a cheap tart who puts price before principle.
My position is that regardless of the circumstances, France will vote no, because she considers this evening that there are no grounds for waging war in order to achieve the goal we have set ourselves to disarm Iraq.
In his interview, the French president mentioned this evening no fewer than four times to stress he didn't think war was justified as of that moment. But Mr. Blair seized on only the first half of President Chirac's statement.
If France or any other country is simply going to say we will veto no matter what, well, that's obviously a very difficult position.
In fact, President Chirac had not said no matter what, as if forever. He had stressed that if the Iraqis ceased to cooperate with the weapons inspectors, war would become inevitable. It just wasn't today. But in Number 10's briefing to the press, neither they nor Mr. Blair mentioned this important qualification. Watching these extraordinary events from close quarters in Number 10 was Sir Stephen Wall, the Prime Minister's European Affairs advisor.
Do you think Downing Street willfully misconstrued what the French president had said?
I wouldn't say willfully misconstrued in this sense, that I think that Tony Blair and other members of the government were convinced that there was no circumstance in which France was prepared to support action.
Ever?
Ever. But if you mean, did they take Chirac's words and take them out of the total context in which they were made, undoubtedly.
I mean, as we know, President Chirac's statement was specifically ce soir, and though it was a very strong statement, a mode 2 or 3 weeks may not have made a difference to him. It wasn't necessarily ruling out a deadline. So there are two factors at work here. There's certainly a strong French view, but there's a strong American view. And you described it to us earlier in our conversation, that you were caught, in a sense, between these two views.
Yes, that's true, but I have to emphasise this. Particularly in the light of all the things that have been said about whether we're misrepresenting the French view or not, we never misrepresented the French view. The French view was absolutely clear. Right? It wasn't that they were against any second resolution. They would perfectly happily have agreed a second resolution, provided it meant a third resolution. And they would have agreed a third resolution, provided it meant a fourth one. What they weren't prepared to do, in any set of circumstances, never mind ce soir, was that they weren't prepared to agree to a resolution with an ultimatum.
If France or any other country is simply going to say, we will veto no matter what, well, that's obviously a very difficult position.
In fact, President Chirac had not said no matter what, as if forever. He had stressed that if the Iraqis ceased to cooperate with the weapons inspectors, war would become inevitable. It just wasn't today.